गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर्स, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस हेयर रूमेटोलॉजी MCQs। दीज आर वेरी वेरी हाई यील्ड MCQs, सो प्लीज गो थ्रू दिस। 35-year-old मैन प्रेजेंट विथ अ 6-month हिस्ट्री ऑफ आर्थ्रालजिया, माउथ अल्सरेशन एंड आई इरिटेशन। On examination, he had some ulceration in the mouth, bilaterally swollen wrist and reduced range of movement of both knees. His investigation shows white cell count 11, C-reactive protein 100, rheumatoid factor negative. So here the diagnosis is, pause this video, think which is the single best answer. So the single best answer here is Behçet syndrome. Let's discuss. Behçet syndrome is multi-system disorder characterized by recurrent oral genital ulceration, eye lesion, anterior and posterior uveitis or retinal vasculitis, skin lesion erythema nodosum, papulopustular lesions, folliculitis and positive Pathergy test. Pathergy phenomena is considered an outstanding features of Behçet disease. Following a needle prick or intradermal injection with saline or dilute histamine, the puncture site becomes inflamed and develops a small sterile pustule due to hyperactivity skin to any intracutaneous insult. Okay. 33-year-old female with systemic lupus erythematosus has arthralgia involving her upper limbs. She also has a butterfly facial rash and a rash on the trunk. Urine dipstick shows no proteinuria or hematuria. Her renal function is normal. Which one of the following medication is most appropriate? So here the most appropriate medicine with arthritis and with skin lesions, best medicine is hydroxychloroquine. Let's discuss. NSAIDs and hydroxychloroquine are used for skin involvement and arthritis. NSAIDs are used for mild disease. Hydroxychloroquine is useful for disease not controlled by NSAIDs. Steroids are used in moderate to severe diseases. Immunosuppressive treatments such as azathioprine, cyclophosphamide are used typically when there is renal or cerebral diseases. 75-year-old woman with long-standing rheumatoid arthritis has great difficulty walking and comments that both her legs are stiff and jumpy. What is the most likely cause of her presentation? It is mainly due to atlanto-axial instability. Cervical cord compression due to atlanto-axial instability is the most likely cause of upper motor neuron nerve weakness. Okay. 50-year-old woman has severe rheumatoid arthritis. She is admitted with worsening breathlessness. She is currently on ibuprofen, methotrexate, celecoxib and paracetamol. On examination, she has features of rheumatoid changes in her hands and looks pale. There is no palpable lymphadenopathy and no abdominal masses. Investigation showed her hemoglobin 7.8, MCV 90 normal, WCC 2.1 low means infection, and platelets low 55. It's pancytopenia here. Reticulocyte count is 0.3. What is the likely cause of anemia? The likely cause of anemia here is treatment with methotrexate. Okay, methotrexate. The patient has an aplastic anemia which can be caused by methotrexate or azathioprine. DMA, RDS, penicillamine or gold, abnormally low reticulocyte count can be attributed to chemotherapy. Aplastic anemia, pernicious anemia, bone marrow malignancies and lower erythropoietin levels. Okay. 65-year-old woman presents with dry eyes and dry mouth. Her investigation shows ANA strongly positive. anti-Rho SSA antibodies strongly positive. Rheumatoid factor positive. Immunoglobulin G markedly elevated 42. IgM and IgA levels are normal. What is likely diagnosis here? So the likely diagnosis here is, this is a case of primary Sjögren's syndrome. Okay. The clinical features are consistent with hypergammaglobulinemia is present in 80% of individuals. ANA anti-Rho antibodies are present approximately 90%. There can be weakly positive rheumatoid factor. 55-year-old female has on long-term steroids for chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. She complains of pain in her right groin radiating down the anterior medial thigh. She has an antalgic gait. On examination of the hip, there is decreased range of movement, especially flexion, abduction, and internal rotation. What is likely diagnosis? Here, the most likely diagnosis is avascular necrosis of the femoral head. A patient on long-term steroids presenting with groin pains radiating to the thigh associated with antalgic gait. Okay. 60-year-old woman on treatment for long-standing rheumatoid arthritis presents with breathlessness. She complains of a dry cough, oxygen saturation found to be 85% on air. Chest X-ray shows a diffuse bilateral interstitial infiltrate. Blood cultures and sputum cultures are negative. Which drug is likely to have caused this adverse effect? This is mainly due to methotrexate. Okay. Pneumonitis is a serious and unpredictable side effect of treatment with methotrexate that may become life-threatening. Chest radiography reveals diffuse interstitial or mixed interstitial and alveolar infiltrate, lower lung fields. Okay. 65-year-old man present has recently developed an acutely painful right knee. On examination, he had temperature of 37.2 degrees Celsius, a hot and swollen right knee. His white cell count, which was raised at 14,000, a knee X-ray showed reduced joint space and chondrocalcinosis. Culture of aspirated fluid showed no growth. What is likely diagnosis here? So here is a case of pseudogout. Let's discuss why pseudogout. Clinical picture is a typically of pseudogout calcification of the articular cartilage would be consistent and the culture results exclude septic arthritis. The diagnosis can be confirmed by the presence of calcium pyrophosphate crystals in a joint fluid demonstrating a positive birefringence under polarized light. 60-year-old man present with painful swollen left knee as well as pain and stiffness of both his hands. On examination, his skin is pigmented, there is tenderness and swelling of the second and third metacarpophalangeal joints of both hands. He has hepatomegaly of 8 cm below the costal margin. His knees swollen and aspiration of the joints yield turbid straw colored fluid. What is likely diagnosis? So the diagnosis here is hemochromatosis. This is a case of hemochromatosis. History of abdominal pain together with skin pigmentation and hepatomegaly suggests the patient has hemochromatosis associated with chondrocalcinosis, which commonly affects second and third metacarpophalangeal joints. The acute arthropathy is likely to be pyrophosphate crystal arthritis. 70-year-old man present with bony swellings of the DIP joints on both hands. They were painful a year ago but are now painless. What is likely diagnosis? So the diagnosis here is Haberden's nodes. This is Haberden node. Most likely diagnosis of osteoarthritis at the DIP joint swelling are known as Haberden nodes, and PIP joints, they are known as Borchardt's nodes. PIP is Borchardt, but DIP is Haberden nodes, which is visible in this picture. See, DIP, distal interphalangeal joint, Haberden node. Okay. 22-year-old Armenian man presents with pain and swelling of the left knee. He also gives a history of recurrent episodes of fever, pleuritic pains in the chest, and generalized rash. These episodes typically last for 2-3 days. Examination reveals splenomegaly, swollen knees and ankles. Urine dipstick reveals 2+ proteinuria. What is likely diagnosis here? So the diagnosis here is familial Mediterranean fever. Let's discuss. Familial Mediterranean fever is inherited condition, characterized by recurrent episodes of painful inflammation in the abdomen, chest or joints. These episodes are often accompanied by fever, sometimes a rash. First episode usually occurs by the age of 20 years, but in some cases the initial attack occurs much later in the life. Typically episodes last 12 to 72 hours, can vary in severity and in the length of time between attacks. 35-year-old man presents acutely with urethritis, conjunctivitis and arthritis. He has been having joint pain in the wrist and hips. On examination, he has rash on the soles of his feet and also kyrcinate balanitis. Rheumatoid factor negative and he has raised inflammatory markers. So the diagnosis here is Ritter's syndrome. Let's discuss why. Ritter syndrome is urethritis, conjunctivitis, seronegative arthritis, cannot see, cannot pee, cannot climb a tree. A typical patient is young man and recent urethritis or dysentery. Seronegative arthritis is usually mono or oligo. Other features are anterior uveitis, keratoderma, bilharziosa, brown abscess on palms and soles, mouth ulcer, plantar fasciitis, Achilles tendinitis, and management usually by NSAID. You can see Ritter's. Okay. 32-year-old man has had a year history of a bilateral hip pains and back pains. There is no past medical history of trauma to the back. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs help to relieve his symptoms. So the diagnosis here is, this is a case of sacroiliitis. Pain and stiffness in the lower back or buttocks, especially in the morning, is a typical of sacroiliitis. It is typically helped by NSAIDs or steroids. X-ray will help to confirm the diagnosis. It is associated with various inflammatory diseases. Example, ankylosing spondylitis or psoriatic arthritis. 35-year-old lady present with stiffness, pain, swelling of her hands and wrist. On examination, she has femur subcutaneous nodules over the elbow, swelling of her wrist, ulnar deviation at metacarpal phalangeal joint, the Dinner Fork deformity and swelling of her proximal interphalangeal joints. Investigation reveals a normocytic normochromic anemia, elevated ESR and CRP. What is most commonly used test which could determine whether she is seropositive? So the most common test here is IgM antibodies. This is a case of rheumatoid arthritis. The patient has a feature of seropositive rheumatoid arthritis, presence of rheumatoid factor. Rheumatoid factor is circulating antibody directed against the Fc fragment of immunoglobulins. The antibody may IgM, IgG or IgA. The commonly employed test detects IgM rheumatoid factor. 32-year-old man has a 6-month history of dry eyes and mouth. Examination, there was evidence of keratoconjunctivitis. parotid gland enlargement, Schimmer test positive. His blood test reveals a positive ANA, Rho and La extranuclear antigen are also positive. So this is a case of Sjögren's syndrome. Sjögren's syndrome is a chronic autoimmune disorder characterized by xerostomia, dry mouth, xerophthalmia, dry eyes and lymphocytic infiltration of exocrine glands. The triad is also known as Sjögren's complex. Schimmer test is probably the only test available in the ED to strongly support or refute suspicion of Sjögren's syndrome. A test strip of filter paper is placed near the lower conjunctival sac to measure tear formation. A positive test occurs when less than 5 mm of filter paper is wet after 5 minutes. Rheumatoid factor ANA, Rho, La antigens are commonly present. As a result of lymphocytic infiltration, 10% of patients may develop pseudolymphoma, a lymphoproliferative process. Approximately 10% of these patients can develop non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. 1% of all patients will have Sjögren's syndrome. Okay. 38-year-old lady present with myalgia, lethargy. Her blood test show positive ANA with titer 1:1024 and rheumatoid factor negative. CK raised. Extranuclear antigen test shows negative Rho and negative La. Negative SCL. SCL70 and positive ribonuclear protein antibody at 160 units. So the diagnosis here is mixed connective tissue disease. This is a case of mixed connective tissue disease. Let's discuss. A positive ANA speckle pattern raised CK and positive anti-RNP antibodies suggest mixed connective tissue disease. Okay. 50-year-old man presents to renal team with uremic symptoms. He also has markedly reduced range of movement at the spine with Schober's test of 10 mm. His CRP is 102, ESR 98. Urine dipstick shows proteinuria 4+. He has had treatment with penicillamine in the past for arthritis. He takes regular ibuprofen. What is most likely cause of his renal symptoms? This is a case of amyloidosis. We can say AA amyloid. Let's discuss. Nephrotic range proteinuria and renal failure in the context of prolonged untreated inflammatory response suggest amyloid AA. Since circulating serum AA is a precursor of amyloid deposits, reduction of the precursor protein is the most rational approach at the present for the management of amyloidosis. Prevention of amyloidosis is preferable to the treatment of established disease. Thus, aggressive therapy of rheumatic disease such as RA and JCA is desirable in this context. 45-year-old woman present with confusion on examination. She was pyrexial. Had levido reticularis, had a blood pressure of 190/100, examination abdomen reveals left flank tenderness, hemoglobin 13.9, WCC 6.5, platelet 110, serum creatinine 95, urine dipstick analysis blood 3+ hematuria, protein 1+ albuminuria. Which of the following test likely to be positive here? So the test positive here is anticardiolipin antibodies. Okay. Diagnosis is SLE and antiphospholipid syndrome. The presentation would be consistent with renal vein thrombosis, flank pain and proteinuria. Antiphospholipid syndrome is a disorder characterized by recurrent venous or atrial thrombosis or fetal losses associated with typical laboratory abnormalities. These include persistently elevated levels of antibodies directed against membrane anionic phospholipids. Okay. 60-year-old lady has polyarthropathy due to rheumatoid arthritis. Which of the following molecules play a central role in pathogenesis? That is TNF-alpha. Why TNF-alpha? Let's discuss. In the context of rheumatoid arthritis, TNF-alpha has involved in cytokine regulation. cell recruitment, angiogenesis, and tissue destruction. Hence, anti-TNF-alpha antibodies such as infliximab are used in therapy. Okay. 50-year-old woman present with breathlessness. She has a 2-year history of Raynaud's. On examination, she had telangiectasia, tight skin around the mouth. Her investigation shows a ESR of 70 and positive anti-centromere antibodies. Which of the following is a typical late complication of this disorder? So the late complication of this disorder is pulmonary hypertension. Okay. 18-year-old girl developed pulmonary hemorrhage and subsequent acute renal failure, requiring dialysis. A renal biopsy shows crescentic glomerulonephritis. Which one of the following antibodies is likely to be present? Anti-myeloperoxidase antibodies present. Let's discuss why. The patient manifests pulmonary renal syndrome, which is commonly due to an ANSA-positive vasculitis, P-ANSA, which correlates with anti-myeloperoxidase antibodies. Highly sensitive and specific towards rapidly progressive glomerulonephritis and hemorrhagic alveolar capillaries. Less commonly, this could be due to good pasture syndrome anti-GBM antibodies. 65-year-old man with chronic leukemia present with symptoms of gout. He was given allopurinol. How does allopurinol prevent accumulation of uric acid by xanthine oxidase inhibitor? Let's see. Xanthine oxidase inhibitor. Allopurinol inhibits xanthine oxidase, the enzyme that catalyzes the conversion of hypoxanthine to xanthine and of xanthine to uric acid. Hypoxanthine and xanthine are breakdown products of purine. Okay. 55-year-old woman with psoriasis has significant joint pains. Which one of the following effective treatment for psoriatic arthropathy, that is by methotrexate. Okay. NSAIDs, sulfasalazine, methotrexate, and TNF-alpha antagonist are useful in psoriatic arthropathy. So guys, I already finished with rheumatology MCQs. If you like this video, please put like on it. And if you're new on my channel, please subscribe it for more new videos. Thank you. Good day. Goodbye. That's all for today.